this video, we're going to be using the formula for the area of a regular polygon. Its area equals 1/2 of the apothem times the perimeter. Let's just go ahead and start off easy. We've got a hexagon, and there's our apothem. It's the distance from the center to the side at a right angle. We're going to make that 6.93 inches. And a side length, we're going to make that 8 inches. And remember that the apothem is just the height of one of those triangles. Those are all going to be congruent in a regular polygon. And the base of each of those triangles is going to be 8 inches. So we could just plug that into a formula that looks like this. Area is going to equal 1/2 base times height for a triangle. Base is going to be 8 inches. The height is 6.93 inches. And n is just going to be how many little triangles there are. It's the number of sides that go around that hexagon. That's 6 sides. So now we just multiply everything together. 1/2 of 8 is 4. Times 6.93 times 6. Use our calculator. 4 times 6.93 is 27.72. And we still need to multiply that. That's the area of one of the triangles. We need to multiply that times 6, because that's how many triangles there are. And so the total area is 166.32. Now remember, we're doing inches times inches. Area is the number of little squares in there. It's inches squared. We're going to use something called unit analysis to figure out about our squared units when we use the formula here. Let's go ahead and do the same problem again, but now it's with 1/2 apothem times perimeter. We still have 1/2. Our apothem is 6.93, and I'm going to write inches here, and I'm going to treat it like it's a variable. You'll see that in a second. And 8 inches times the number of sides, which is 6, is going to give us our total perimeter. So now we have 1/2 of 6.93 inches, and our 8 inches times 6 is going to give us our perimeter, which is 48 inches. So we're going to keep that 1/2 this time. Let's go ahead and multiply these two together in our calculator. It gives you 332.64, and inches times inches is inches squared. Now the last step, we're just going to cut everything in half. You divide it by 2 in your calculator. 166.32 inches squared is the total area. So let's try a pentagon. Pentagon has 5 sides. Let's go ahead and put our apothem right there, and let's call it 6.88 centimeters. And our side length is going to be 10 centimeters. Again, that's going to be the height and base of those triangles. So you can always just find the area of the triangles times 5, but let's use our formula. It's 1/2 of the apothem, the 6.88 centimeters. Times our perimeter. Perimeter is going to be 10 centimeters times 5 sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides on a pentagon. And I'm going to go ahead and rewrite 1/2 of the 6.88 centimeters. And our perimeter, again, is going to be 5 times 10 is 50 centimeters. So I'm going to go ahead and write it that way. Now here, instead of multiplying those out, I'm going to go ahead and cut the first number in half. Everything's multiplication here, so the order really doesn't matter. 1/2 of 6.88 is 3.44. It's still centimeters. I'm going to multiply that times 50 centimeters in my calculator. Remember, centimeters times centimeters is going to give me centimeters squared. 3.44 times 50 is 172, and centimeters times centimeters is centimeters squared. Let's try another one. And this is an octagon. It has 8 sides. We could put the apothem here, but I'm going to put it up here. Just to show you, it could be anywhere. It's always the height of those little triangles. It's the distance from the center to the side. We'll make it 18.47 meters, and a side will be 12 meters. Let's go ahead and plug those in. The total area is going to be 1/2. Of 18.47 meters times our perimeter, which is going to be 12 meters times 8 sides. So our area is 1/2 times the 18.47 meters. And again, our perimeter is 8 times 12, that's 96 meters. And this time I'll go ahead and multiply those out, then cut everything in half. Let's keep that 1/2 on the side. We'll do that last. 18.47 times the 96, and our calculator is 1,773.12. And again, meters times meters is meters squared. And last but not least, we're going to cut everything in half. Just say divide by 2. And it gives us 886.56 meters squared. Okay, so on this last one, we're not going to know the apothem. We're going to take a decagon, and we're going to know everything except for the apothem, and we're going to use our formula to solve for it. So we're just going to make that A. A side is going to be 15 feet, and we're going to be given that the total area is 1,731 square feet. So let's try plugging that in and solve for the little a. Big A, the area, is the 1,731 feet squared, and I write feet squared in my equation. That'll be important later. I have 1/2 times A. I don't know what A is. I just write it as a variable. And perimeter is 15 times 10. Just go ahead and write 150. Oh, wait a second. I need to write feet. So I'm going to take that off. Remember, I'm doing unit analysis. I'm going to see what happens to feet and feet squared at the end. So, the order doesn't matter when you multiply. So I'm going to put the 1/2 next to the 150. I'm going to cut the 150 in half. So 1/2 times 150 feet. And again, that's times A. That's the commutative property. I can move things around with multiplication. So I cut the 150 feet in half. That becomes just 75. 1/2 of 150 is 75 feet. Times A. Now I want to get A by itself, so I have to divide 75 on both sides. And remember, on the other side it says feet squared. What's going to happen to feet? Well, I have 1,731, and I'm going to treat feet like they are a variable. Feet squared is feet times feet. So let's go ahead and erase this, make this all go away. And I'm going to write it like that. 1,731 times feet times feet. I can barely make it fit. And that will make it so that those two eliminate. Times feet divided by feet, they are eliminated. The same thing will happen on the other side. So here I have division. I get 23.08, and there's 1 foot left on top, and I write that one. Now, 75 divided by 75, that goes away, and I'm left with A. That's my final answer. So when you're trying to solve for a part of this, just plug it into your formula and solve it like a normal equation.